Hello students, today we will be talking about the six limbs of painting, that is Shardanga. So the six limbs of painting are Rupa Bheda, Pramanam, Bhavam, Lavanya Yojanam, Sadrishyam, Varnika Bhangam. So these are the six basic limbs of painting, or known as Shardanga. So if I have to talk about Shardanga or the six limbs of painting, this Shardanga, it comes from the word Shard plus Anga. Shard means six, and Anga means part. So there are six parts. In India, since the first century BC, it had seen the evolution of Shardanga. It is just like the first principles of art. The first form is Rupa Veda. These particular six limbs of painting had been put up in the form of a slokam. Rupa Bheda Pramanani Bhava Labanya Yojanam Sadrishyam Varna Bhangam Iti Chitram Shardagam. This is the slok which talks about the six limbs of painting. The first one is Rupa Bheda. Rupa Bheda is knowledge of appearance. So Rupa means the form, and Bheda means differentiation or characterization in its individual manner. It can be living or non-living. Rupa Bheda is basically the knowledge of appearance, how it looks like. The object of the subject are classified as jiva, that is living, and ajiva, that is non-living. And the living is again divided as uttam, which is superior, madhyam, category of concerts, adham, a category of demons, all disgust, ugly looking creatures. And non-living consists of the whole background, like clouds, mountains, and all those things. So Rupa Bheda, it will showcase a deep, detailed variation in the whole diversity in the world. For example, humans and their types of gods, goddesses, kings, queens, common people, animals, if deers. So there will be a differentiation in between trees with different variety and so on. Rupa Bheda consists in the knowledge of special characteristics of things, natural or man-made. Say the differences in appearance among many types of men, women, or natural objects or other subjects of the painting. Rupa is the form. It may be visual or mental. Whereas Bheda is difference. So such as the difference between forms instinct with life and beauty, and the forms which have no beauty or no life, ajiva. So difference between jiva and ajiva. So Rupa Bheda will enable you to differentiate between a dead person and a sleeping person. If we talk about an example of Rupa Bheda, the Padmapani painting from Ajanta cave number 1, so many forms are visible. Now Padmapani, a form of Buddha holding a blue lily, showcased like a youthful king with luxury and charm, standing along with princes at Kinnaras, animals like donkeys and birds. In the background, with the architectural scene trees and plants and figures with different colors, complexions, poses, and performing actions. In Basholi painting of clouds made along with the interesting variety of ghosts and debris submerging with the clouds, not only visually appealing, but also a deep thought of conceptual features behind it. It makes a kind of soundful subject to the viewer and speaking in itself, as every cloud with its own individual characterization or rupabhed. The second limb is pramana. Pramana, it means in Indian philosophy, the means by which one obtains accurate and valid knowledge about the world. It is just proportion, a correct proportion that is being followed. It is the correct spatial perception of the object painted and the main and maintaining a sense of harmony, balance, and a sense of proportion within the figure and also in relation to the other figures and to the painting as a whole. The sense of proportion also extended to the way major figures are depicted by placing at the center and surrounding them with lesser figures and smaller sizes, symbolizing the status with the main figure. The Indian artists were guided more by the proportions than by absolute measurement. The proportions were often symbolic and suggestive. In the painting taken from Ajanta Caves with the subject Explanation of the Dream by Maya Devi, the mother of Buddha, Maya Devi is standing in a very harmonious pose along with the servants with a support of a pillar. Because she is a queen, she is indifferent in color complexion with the Indian red and with a high proportion in size and the rest of the figures with opposite color scheme and smaller in size, which means in the painting of Trivikrama, the fifth incarnation of Lord Vishnu, he is shown as monumental size as he made victory of the three worlds with the 3 feet measurement. 1 foot on Swarga, that is heaven, 2nd foot on Prithvi, that is earth, and finally he put his 3rd foot on the head of demon Bali to destroy his arrogance. This was from the Vamana avatar. So he is the winner of the 3 worlds. He is shown gigantic in the height and rest of the figures are smaller in size. The third limb is bhava. Bhava is emotion. It states of mind translated as feeling, emotion, mood, devotional state of mind, emotional energies created through the painting. It is the expression of character which fulfills the meaning of the painting and concept or story behind. The Natya Shastra identifies 8 rasas with 8 correspondings. So is the mood. You have Shridgaram, which is love, attractiveness. Hasyam, which means laughter, comedy. Rodram, which is fury or anger. Karunyam, which is compassion, sorrow. Vibhatsyam, disgust, aversion.
भयानकम, हॉरर, टेरर, विरम, हीरोइक मूड, समथिंग विच इज़ वेरी हीरोइक एंड अद्भुतम, समथिंग दैट इज वंडर विच इज आउट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, एस्टॉनिशमेंट. सो हियर इन यू कैन फाइंड दिस अगेन इन द एग्जाम्पल. देर आर सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स रिप्रेजेंट एक्सप्रेशन एंड इमोशनल क्वालिटीज. इन पद्मपाणि, because he is Buddha, the expression of the prince is peaceful, compassionate, subtle and serene. In the Sitanavasala painting subjected to Krishna's romance, where Krishna is playing flute in the center of Ashtagopis, the eight lovers, each and every character smiling in maze and enjoying the company of romantic hero Krishna. In the painting of Durga Mahishasuramardini, where the female hero goddess Durga, with power and proud showcase, veer and victorious expression, whereas goddess Kali and Lord Narasimha makes a fear to the demons through the terrified horror expression. The next one is Lavanya Yojanam. Lavanya Yojanam is infusion of grace or artistic representation. It is a planning to create beautiful, graceful environment along with the beauty of the character. For example, Krishna Ras, who is the highly atheistical beauty, grace, charm in Krishna and gopis. Same feeling will be infused in the environment, where whether trees, plants, foliage, flowers, animals and birds. The form of and posture itself will be so speaking, so that the meaning will be completed. For example, in a painting where a princess admiring her beauty in mirror, fully decorated with jewels and ornaments, standing along with the servants, holding a plate of makeup and a whisk, because the painting has a subject of beauty. The whole environment with a variety of beautiful foliages and the pose and the posture itself is very graceful. And next, the last one is Sadrishyam. That is resemblance, which means how faithful a picture is to be original. Achieving credible resemblance to the object of the world around and to the person. The resemblance are not mere general, but extend to detail too. It enhance the character of any individual and make him complete in itself. For example, Mrignayani, eyes like a deer, nose should be like a parrot beak, waist should be like a tree trunk, thighs should be like a banana trunk, fingers like lotus petals, lips like fresh clustered flowers, etc. So there are 32 characteristics of great men. Level feet, thousand spoked wheel sign of feet, long slender fingers, pliant hands and feet, toes and fingers finely webbed, full sized heels, arched steps, thighs like royal stag, hands reaching below the knees, well recreated male organ, height and stretch of arms equal, every hair root dark colored, body hair graceful and curly, golden hued body, 10 foot aura around him, soft smooth skin, soles, palms, sole, shoulders and crown of head well rounded, area below armpits well filled, lion-shaped body erect and upright, full round shoulder, 40 teeth, teeth white, even and close, 4 canine teeth, pure white, jaw like a lion, saliva that improves the taste of all food, tongue long and broad, voice deep and resonant, eyes deep blue, eyelashes like a royal bull, white urna curl that emits light between eyebrows, fleshy protuberance on the crown of the head. So these are the six limbs of painting. They are Rupabhed, Pramanam, Bhava, Lavanya Yojanam, Sadrisham, and Varnika Bhanga. Varnika Bhanga is artistic manner of using brush and colors, mainly seen in the Tagore painting. So, again to repeat the shlok, Rupa Bheda Pramanani Bhava Lavanya Yojanam Sadrisham Varna Bhangam Iti Chitram Shadakam. Thank you.